This is always my greatest worry in the summertime, a thunderstorm stalling over the Greater Toronto Area. It is one of the most costly natural disasters to occur. Now, luckily, I'm not forecasting that. The storm should remain just north of the GTA, and they're not really going to stall over the core of Toronto. But the atmosphere is really unstable through Tuesday afternoon. You can see it on satellite imagery, the thunderstorm activity popping up along Lake Breeze boundaries. We're getting that cooler air surging inland at times, cooler in quotes. It's more like feels like the upper 30s versus the low to mid 40s inland. So here's the future radar. There's a chance of some morning convection. I know you had that natural lightning alarm clock early Tuesday morning. The chance of a repeat is on the low side, but it's not zero. And there it is. By the mid-afternoon, we get one round of storm, potentially accumulating rain, 30 to 50 millimeters. And then a secondary round of thunderstorms, a cluster wants to push through late Wednesday evening. So there will be some lightning potential with this setup. There's the lightning Wednesday afternoon and evening, really anchoring on that Lake Breeze boundary. We'll get into a more localized feel through the GTA. So you can see those Lake Breeze boundaries dancing on your screen. You saw that little blip. That was an early morning storm that we're not ruling out. Then through the afternoon and evening, these storms up towards Vaughan, Newmarket, along the 401, Brampton, Woodbridge. Hopefully all of that activity is done by late Wednesday evening. You can run out some of the rainfall totals. Now, don't take this at face value. This is just another model for downtown Toronto showing the possibility of heavy cells in and around Forest Hill, Yorkdale. Again, that heaviest bullseye, quite uncertain. But keep in mind, that is our biggest risk and why we put severe possible on our risk map.